We need datasets to create AI. And as datasets get better, the use of AI becomes more effective. When people with disabilities are not represented in datasets, the models that get created are not inclusive and do not work for everyone. When that happens, we call it a data desert. Microsoft's AI for Accessibility program is one way we're trying to address the data desert to improve disability representation and diversity in AI. As an example, one of our grantees, University of Texas Austin, worked to evolve the VisWiz dataset, a dataset of images submitted explicitly by people who are blind or have low vision. They tried to build machine learning models that would adapt to the lighting and framing characteristics of the images that are unique to photos taken by people who are blind or have low vision. For large models, outliers in the data tend to fall away, so it's important to ensure whatever representation of disability exists in a data set is prioritized within AI models that come from the data. Yuta Trevoranis, a professor at OCAD University in Toronto, addresses this with what she calls the lawnmower of justice. By cutting all but a small number of repeats of any given data point, you can force the learning model to level the playing field for the full spectrum of needs and pay attention to the edge or outlying data as well. It might be helpful to know that the edge or outlying data is often where the data that represents people with disabilities is found. So the lawnmower makes sure that they are represented in the data. More recently, a grantee at City University London enlisted the help of people who are blind or had low vision for the research project Orbit to improve recognition of personal objects in AI systems. We believe accessibility is raising the bar for what AI can deliver, including people with disabilities, and always taking an inclusive design approach is a critical part of the journey. As an example of what happens when you don't collaborate with people with disabilities, sign language gloves might seem cool and amazing, but in the design process, they didn't account for the fact that sign language is more than hand gestures. It's about body language, facial expressions, and uses a unique grammar. If they had included people who were deaf, they could have designed a more authentic and functional AI tool. As you work to understand the disability data desert in your own work, we encourage you to ask the three design justice questions: who benefits, who is potentially harmed, and who participates. These questions align with the Microsoft Responsible AI principles and practices and will help your team build AI that has a positive impact. Join us in making products more accessible by building data sets and models with and by people with disabilities. Thanks for watching.